Hey everybody, thanks for tuning back into Otram's YouTube channel. Today we've got a 96 FZJ80 in the shop. It's getting a bunch of oil seals and gaskets done. And we've got the valve cover off because we were doing valve cover gasket, distributor O-ring, and we had the fuel injectors out of it to clean and flow test those. While we've got everything apart, I figured it'd be a good time to shoot a valve adjustment check video on the 1FZ. It's rare that I see these go out of spec, but since the valve cover's off, we may as well go ahead and check them. So the first step is you want to go down to your crank pulley, and unfortunately I couldn't get that on camera, but we're spinning that around to zero, top dead center. And there's two gears here at the front of the head. And if you look on the back of them, you'll see a single dot on each one and then a double dot on the outside edge. If the single dots are meshed in the middle and the double dots line up outside, then you know you're at top dead center for cylinder number one. And when you're at top dead center for cylinder number one, you can check the clearance on 1, 3, and 5 on the exhaust valves. And I just lost my place. 1, 2, and 4 on the intake side. So what I normally do is just take a magic marker and I mark out the first set. I don't know if you can see it in the picture, but there's little yellow marks here next to the head. That just lets me keep track of which valves I'm adjusting with each spin of the engine. Anyway, so now we're at top dead center. And I thought I had my fuel gauges over here, but I didn't. So the spec on these is 6/1000ths to 10/1000ths on the intake and 10/1000ths to 14/1000ths of clearance on the exhaust. So what I normally do is go to the medium. So I set it for 8/1000ths and 12/1000ths. And let me get these spun around and I'll show you on camera. So I'll use an 8/1000ths on the intake side and a 12/1000ths on the exhaust side. Because normally you can go through and if the medium or the median fits well, then you know you're in pretty good shape. If I get one that either feels really loose or really tight, I'll go back with the extreme ends of the spectrum. Like I'd go in with a 6 or a 10 on the intake just to double check. So let's start up here and we're gonna start on the intake and number one and just slide it down under here. And that one is a bit tight on 8, but this one feels right. And what you're feeling for is in between the cam lobe and the shim bucket. So this one is tight. Let me get it swung back around. It's tight on number 8. So what I'd do is go back and grab my 6/1000ths feeler gauge out. And my 6/1000ths goes in. With plenty of clearance, so that one's probably at like 7/1000ths. So we're within spec on those two. We can move on, check this next one back. That one goes, that one feels good, and you just want like a slight bit of drag. You shouldn't really have to force it in there, and it also shouldn't slop around. So, okay, all our intakes are good. So we'll switch over to our 12/1000ths and see how our exhausts feel. That one's a little bit snug, but the gauge goes through it. That one's happy. That one we're gonna wanna come back and check. That one too. That one we're going to check again. and that one. Okay, so these were snug. So we were checking with 12 thousandths. So we're gonna drop back to a 10 thousandths because that's the bottom of the range on the exhaust side. Okay, so 10 thousandths fits there, fits there, and there. And some of these back ones are tricky to get in on with everything in the way. And you can't actually see that one, so we're not gonna really worry about it. But that one's good. So all of our first row are within spec. So we're gonna go one revolution of the crank. Back to zero. And that brings up the opposite set of cam lobes from what we were checking before. So then we can go back through and check these. So like that one there is good. That one's tight, which it's weird. Normally, when I go through these, they all seem to be really good right on the median. So we'll check it. Okay, yeah, 10 thousandths on this one's loose. So we're, you know, we're within spec. So we would go through and all of the ones that we didn't check the first time around, we'll check this time around. So anything that doesn't have a yellow paint pen gets checked in the second round. So unlike the old ones where you check the adjustment with a screwdriver and a lock nut, these have a shim that's down underneath of here. And you need, don't want to drop that in. Set of valve adjusting tools. And these guys, you basically just stick them on there. And as you roll them around, it pushes the follower bucket down. And then you can take this guy and wedge it in between the cam and the lifter bucket. And it'll hold the bucket down far enough that you can fish the shim out of it with a magnet and a little pocket screwdriver. There's a little groove down here on the bucket that lets you get a pocket screwdriver in there so that you can pick up on that and break the oil tension and get it out with a magnet. And then from there, there's a chart in the factory manual that if you measured X clearance and you need Y, so you've got, you know, your hair too tight, so you'd look up how much you're too tight by and what shim you have existing, and you cross-reference it in the table, and it'll give you the correct shim thickness. So then you just, you know, call up your local Toyota dealer, tell them which shims you need, and they'd likely have to special order it and get you in the shims. The only time I've ever actually had to go through and re-shim one of these is somebody else had done a head gasket job on it, and they didn't label where the shims went when they took them out, and they just put them back in wherever. And one of the exhaust valves ended up getting burnt because it had the wrong shim. The shim was too tight and it was keeping the exhaust valve open. So once the new exhaust valve was put in, it had to be re-shimmed to account for it. Anyway, just thought I would go through and show you guys valve clearance adjustments on a 1FZ real quick while I had it apart. Hope you enjoyed what you saw. If you did, please subscribe below and we'll see you next time. Thanks.